A very hearty welcome to the all my students of Open Mind channel. So I'm Sandhya, back to you again, starting with a new chapter of physics which is called as magnetic effects of electric current. Now in my previous classes you went through electricity. Now we'll be seeing how the magnetic effects of electric current can be used in various ways to run the electrical appliances. Now from the name only it is very clear that magnetic effects of electric current, that means when the electric current is passing through some conductor, there is some kind of magnetic field produced around it, so which is called as magnetic fields of electric current. Okay, so now for that, first you should know even what is a magnet. Okay, so you know what is a magnet? The magnets are of two kinds. The one is the natural magnet. Natural magnet, we get it in the form of ores. Example is hematite. You know what is a hematite ore? Hematite ore is a iron ore. Or you can say it is an iron ore. The second one is artificial magnet. Artificial magnet examples are bar magnet, horseshoe magnets and etc. Okay. Now, I spoke to you about bar magnet. Now, what is a bar magnet? A bar magnet is generally in this rectangular shape. This is the north pole of the bar magnet and this is the south pole of the bar magnet. Okay. Now, if you draw an imaginary line from the center of the magnet. Okay. So, suppose I am drawing an imaginary line from the center of the magnet such that it divides the bar magnet into two equal parts. Then this is called as magnetic axis. What is this called as? Magnetic axis. M-A-G-N-E-T-I-C, magnetic axis. And the distance between this to this, that means the distance between one pole of the magnet to the another pole is called as effective length. What it is called as? Effective length. And it is indicated by small l. So, I hope these things are clear to you, that how many types of magnets are there. One is a natural magnet which is called as hematite ore or some other bauxites, and artificial magnets are bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, etc. Now, what is a magnet? So, this is the magnet in which we have the two poles, north and south. The line which is dividing the bar magnet into two equal parts, that is called as magnetic axis, and the distance between the two poles of the magnet is called as effective length. Apart from that, when you keep a magnet, you might see up to a certain range, it has the magnetic effect. If you go after this, there is no magnetic effect. So this is called as magnetic field or magnetic region. So they may ask you, what is a magnetic field or a magnetic region? So you have to say that whenever we place a magnet and up to whatever area the magnetism is being effected, that means if you bring some iron nails or something, it gets attracted towards the magnet, that part is called as magnetic field or magnetic region. And if you divide, if you break a magnet on from its magnetic axis, again the bar magnet gets divided into two parts, each having one pole which is called as north pole and south pole. So if I divide this, again this will become south and this will become north. So 1 will get divided into 2, 2 will get divided into 4, 4 will get divided into 8 and so on. So now we will see how the electric current gives you a kind of magnetic effects which helps to run some electrical appliances like motor, generator, etc. Now let's start with another topic. So now we will see how the magnetic effects of electric current, with the help of an activity, we will see the effects. Okay. Now suppose this is a conductor. I made it a little bit dark so that you can understand that it is a conductor. Okay. So now it is being placed on a cardboard piece. So this is the cardboard piece and this is the metal conductor. You can take it a copper wire just by making a hole, and this entire thing is being connected with the help of a battery, with a cell or a battery, anything, it's your wish. Then you have to connect it with an ammeter. Then it is connected with the help of a key. Then it is completed in this way. Okay. So, sorry, the direction of the flow of the current will be from positive to negative. So, this can't be possible. So, you have to make the directions as such. Okay, now what did I say to you? This is this part which I made it dark. Now this is actually the conductor. The conductor is, I took it as a copper wire. You can take it as any conductor. Basically, I said to you in the chapter of electricity that copper is the best conductor of electricity. Apart from that, if you are unable to get the copper wires, you can use the aluminium wire in place of it. So now, whenever we take a copper wire like this way and it's been connected to the entire circuit, we see that some amount of current flows through the conductor. Mostly most of the current flows through the conductor because the resistance of the conductor is very low. Now suppose we keep a magnetic needle on this. You know what is a magnetic needle? The magnetic needle is also called as compass. So compass or magnetic needle, the meaning is same. It's a small round shaped dial type of a thing which helps you to gives you the direction. So even if you want, you can take it and anywhere if you stand, it will give you the directions of the earth, that which is north, which is south and which is east and which is west. Basically it shows you the north and south direction. East and west you can easily find out with the help of that. So whenever we insert the key, some amount of current flows to the circuit. Whenever some amount of current flows to the circuit, there is some deflections in the magnetic needle. Now why this deflection is happening? There is a question, it might be in your mind, that why it is causing a deflection in the magnetic needle. It is causing because whenever the electric current is passing through a conductor, it produces a magnetic field around it. It is due to that magnetic field that the magnetic needle is getting deflected. So from this activity, we can prove that electric current is producing the magnetic field. Now when you stop the flow of current, when you insert the key and when you open the key, you stop the flow of current. The stop the flow of the current means none of the current is flowing to the circuit now. When no current is flowing to the circuit, there will be no deflection in the magnetic needle. So this proves that electric current produces a magnetic field. Now we'll see an activity that how the what are magnetic lines of forces. Now here we'll be doing another activity, what is magnetic field. So as I said you when I start my classes, that suppose you take a bar magnet like this way, this is the north pole and this is the south pole of the magnet. Now when you place it up to a certain region only, it will have the magnetic effect. This particular field is called as magnetic field, or it is also called as magnetic region. Now we will see what are magnetic field of lines. Okay. So for this, you can do an activity. This part, you can do it in your home. Just take a very big chart paper, place it, we need the four paper pins, place it like this way. Take the chart paper first, place it on a wooden board with the help of four paper pins on the four corners. After that, place the bar magnet like this way. So this is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. And this is the geographical North Pole and this is the geographical South Pole. That means North pointing North, South pointing South. Geographical North Pole means it is the North Pole of the Earth and that is the North Pole of the, and that is the South Pole of the Earth. So now when you keep the magnetic needle over here, you can see the deflection like this way. So in that way you have to mark the dots, so we will get the imaginary lines like this way, like this way. Okay, here also we get imaginary lines whenever you keep the magnetic needle. You keep the magnetic needle like this way, it shows the deflection. Put a point there. Again remove the needle, wherever the last point it was there, put the needle again over there, you get. So whenever you remove the needle, you get imaginary lines like this way. So these are called as magnetic lines of forces. What are these called as? These are called as magnetic lines of forces. Now the magnetic lines of forces have some characteristics, or it has some properties. So this is north pointing north. Always remember, north pointing north, south pointing south, you will get this closed curves. So these closed curves are called as magnetic lines of forces. So what are the characteristics of magnetic lines of forces? The first is, they start from the north pole and they ends at the south pole. So you can write it down. I'm writing it short. Please elaborate this point while you're writing it in your answer sheet. Starts from north pole, ends at south pole. Okay. What is the second point? The intensity is maximum at the poles and it is minimum at the equator. Can you see this is the equator? So it is minimum at the equator, the intensity of the lines. So intensity is maximum at poles and minimum at equator. Third one is that they are always equidistant from each other. They are equidistant from each other.
What is the fourth point?
The fourth point is that inside the bar magnet, the magnetic lines of force move from south to north. Remember, outside it is moving from north to south, inside it will go from south to north. So the first point is, as I said you, they are equidistant from each other. Since they are equidistant from each other, they will never intersect with each other. Second thing, intensity is maximum at poles and it is minimum at the equator. From the figure we can easily find it out. Third, it starts at north pole and it ends at south pole. And the fourth point is, if you draw a tangent at any point of the magnetic lines of force, it gives us the direction of magnetic field. So drawing a tangent at any point of the magnetic lines of forces gives you the direction of magnetic field. Gives direction of magnetic field. Magnetic field. So I hope it is clear to you now. So what is the first point I said you? They never intersect with each other. They are always equidistant from each other. They start from north pole, ends at the south pole. The intensity is maximum at the poles and it is minimum at the equator. If you draw a tangent at any point at the magnetic lines of forces, it gives you the direction of magnetic field. So this is the way we get the magnetic lines of forces. When the north pole of the bar magnet represents towards the geographical north pole and the south pole of the bar magnet represented towards the geographical south pole. Now we will see vice versa what happens. Now we will see, this is the bar magnet, this is the north pole of the magnet and this is the south pole of the magnet. Now in the previous activity we did north pointing north, here we will be doing north pointing south. So this is the south of the geographical south and this is the geographical north. So geographical north. In this way, whenever we do the activity, in this way we don't get a closed curves, we get the open curves like this way. So we get the open curves like this way. Since they are magnetic lines of forces, the properties or the characteristics remains the same, but here only you might have seen that since the intensity will be maximum in place of equator and it will be minimum in case of poles, rest of the characteristics remains the same as we did before. So this is an activity in order to find out that how the magnetic fields of lines effects or how the magnetic lines of fields looks like when the north of the bar magnet pointed towards the north of the earth and the north or the north of the bar magnet pointed towards the south, that is the geographical south pole of the earth. So you can do this activity in your lab or in your home and you can see the different kinds of magnetic lines of forces. So this is the way today we saw what is a magnet, how we can understand that the current carrying conductor produces a magnetic field. We learned what is magnetic axis, what is effective length and what is the symbols represented the effective length, that is small l, and even we learned the magnetic lines of forces, how it can be made by making the north pole of the bar magnet pointing towards the geographical north and the south pole of the bar magnet pointing towards the geographical south pole, and we saw the different characteristics of the magnetic lines of forces. Now in my next class we will be seeing the other topics of magnetic fields of effective current. So till then, bye bye from Sandhya, see you in my next upcoming video.
For more updates, subscribe our channel, click the show links and enjoy watching the videos.